So there's my cat right in the middle of my filming setup.
Huckleberry!
So this was caught off camera, but as I was paying attention to Finn, Huckleberry decided that he was going to chew my wires.
And Finn's scratching the couch! Stop it!
Life with kittens, am I right? Oh, I'm still recording. Haha. Now, hopefully the fact that there's a giant window behind this green screen is not going to affect anything. Knowing my luck, it probably will. But hopefully it won't, and probably I'm like standing in like a graveyard or something, so. Hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to be talking about the most cursed paintings ever. But before we get started, my name is Sophia Lovelace and I post about ghosts, ghouls, anything creepy and cool. So if you like any of that stuff, make sure to hit the subscribe button down below to be notified when I have new uploads. Also, when you're down there, make sure to hit the bell icon. That way you're notified when I have premieres, which is an opportunity for you to chat with me live as we watch my video together. And as always, make sure to follow any of my social medias. And if you have any questions, make sure to private message me. Thank you guys so much for sticking around during the month of October. I know it didn't go as well as I planned, but you know, it's a new month, it's a new start. Let's try this again. I'm gonna try to upload every Friday, and if I do bonus uploads, that would be fantastic. Anyways, moving on to these cursed paintings. Number one is the Anguished Man. No one knows exactly this painting's origins, but it is known that the artist mixed his blood in with the paint before committing suicide. The current owner, Sean Robertson, inherited it from his grandmother, who swore up and down that it was haunted. After hanging up the painting, the family began to hear whispering and crying. However, what makes this painting scarier than all the other paintings on this list is that there is video footage of paranormal activity that is a result of this painting, which I will play for you now.
The picture of the Anguished Man back up in the top bedroom. I'm gonna record it for approximately 8 hours, see if we can catch some of the activity on video. I'll just give you a quick look at the painting first, close up. As you can see, some of the paint is starting to crack. It's still on its original wooden frame. Some of the canvas seems to be coming off at the bottom there and here. But apart from that, I think it's in reasonable condition considering its age. So I'm going to set up the recording equipment and leave it for approximately 8 hours, and I'll leave the light on.
think of that footage? Is it real or fake? As always, you decide and leave your thoughts in the comments section down below. Number two is Untitled Painting or Paintings. This Polish painter's unique art usually depicts scenes from hell, causing people to believe that his paintings are cursed. The majority of his paintings are untitled. Reportedly, he left several paintings untitled. And then one day, he took several of the paintings and burned them in his backyard without showing anyone any of them. In 1998, his wife passed away, and 1 year later, his son committed suicide. 6 years after that, he was found murdered in his apartment. Because of the very strange events that happened after he painted these paintings, several people believe that he and his family were cursed because of his paintings. And it is said that anyone who looks at these paintings for an extended period of time will die. Number three is the Rain Woman. Now, the artist who created this painting said that it only took her 5 hours to complete. And the entire time that she was painting it, she felt as if someone else was guiding her hand, and that she didn't actually create it herself. Anyone who has owned the painting has either returned it or resold it, complaining of insomnia, sleep problems, and hearing strange noises. Now, this one is another one of my favorites, and it is titled Man Proposes and God Disposes. Now, this scene depicts the imaginary ending of Sir John Franklin's expedition in 1845, which in real life he disappeared without a trace. Held in the University of London, it is covered with a Union flag every year during exam season. The reason for this is in the 1970s, a student committed suicide and stated that polar bears made me do it. Other students have reported being uneasy when seeing the polar bears. Now, I think this is because this painting is held in like an exam hall, so that's why students are writing exams in that room and that's why they feel uncomfortable. Now, exams are already stressful enough. The last thing I need is to see this scary polar bear ripping human flesh. Just really not a good picture. Now, this one is a very popular painting, and if you're into the paranormal at all, you've probably seen this one. And it is The Hands Resist Him. So it was painted in 1972, but in February 2000, it was named the eBay Haunted Painting. Apparently, the figures move at night, with some reporting that the figures disappear from the frame. And get this, not only did the painter, but the owner of the gallery and an art critic died 1 year after seeing this painting. But what do you think? Do you think this painting is haunted? Thank you guys so much for watching. I know this was a little bit shorter of a video than I normally do, but I thought it would be a really fun one, a pretty educational one, so I thought I would do it. But if you like this video, make sure to please give it a big thumbs up because it really helps me out. And if you want to see more of my videos, make sure to hit the subscribe button. Like I said before, I post about ghosts, ghouls, anything creepy and cool, so if you like any of that stuff, make sure to hit the subscribe button. And I think that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys next time, and